Welcome to Celebrating Act Two. Celebrating Act Two is the user manual for the second half of your life.
Does size matter? Yes, it does. In this video, we're going to talk about the benefits of different size dogs so you can really determine what size will work best for you, for your perfect pet, when you decide to go out and bring home a new dog. My name is Sarah Surritt with Get Pawsitive Dog Training. And today's topic again is all about size. And at first, I have a question for you. I want you to ask yourself, why am I getting a dog? Why is it important to you to have a dog in the first place? So many of my clients have mentioned to me they want a dog. They want someone there when they walk in the door to greet them. They want a dog to cuddle with on the couch. They want a dog for their children. They want a dog to go hiking with. They want a dog to travel with. So why do you want a dog? What is your interest in having a dog in your life? So the first few things I want you to consider all about size are these areas. First is your lifestyle. What is your lifestyle? Are you home? Are you active? Because depending on what your lifestyle is, this might directly correlate to the size of the dog that you consider bringing home. And the other question to consider is, what about your children or grandchildren? If you bring home a large dog, is that going to be safe for your children? Are you ready to set your children and the dog up for success with lots of management and prevention so that dog doesn't knock over the children or get to the children or practice behaviors that you don't want with the children? And the other thing is cost. I want you to consider the cost of your dog, because the smaller the dog, the less food you have to feed your dog, which is a monthly expense. And the bigger the dog, the bigger the poops you have to clean up. So that's something I want you to consider as well. Next, I want you to consider the space that you have in your home. Do you have a yard? Do you have a front yard? Do you have a backyard? Is it gated? Is it safe? Are you in an apartment? Are you in an easy, accessible place for a dog of a large size to be able to romp and roam? What is that gonna look like if you bring home a small dog? Will they have a place to pee in the house on a potty pad? Or will you take them out to the balcony? What about a large dog? Where are they gonna go? So this is an important thing to consider when bringing home a new dog, because it's not fair to the dog if you keep them locked up in an apartment all day for 7 hours and try to get them out to go potty. It's just not fair. We want to make sure that we're giving them ample space and fulfilling their needs as well for exercise as well as stimulation in the environment. Okay. Last, I want you to think about your strength. Whether you are a senior or in your 40s or you're just out of college, how much strength do you have? Because you can go with a big dog that has a lot of power and can knock you over or pull you to the ground, or you can go with a small dog, and sometimes those little small dogs are very mighty. But that's something you might want to consider, is the size of your dog in relation to the strength and how much you want to be able to walk without feeling like you're not in control, or being able to hold the dog should he get excited about seeing your best friend come into the house or across the street, or seeing his best friend who's a dog walking down the street. And of course, all of that is rightly directed to training. So you also want to train your dog to have calmness and focus and attention on you when on leash, right? All right, so let's talk about the different size, because if your strength and your yard is not up to par, you're gonna probably wanna avoid the large breed dogs like the Bernese Mountain Dogs or the Mastiffs, which range from 110 plus pounds, all muscle and strength, right? And then there's also the 60 to 80 pound dogs like the Labradors and the Goldens, maybe some of the Pit Bulls and the Shepherds. So ask yourself, you know, what size dog would you see in your home? Now, if you already have a dog in your home, maybe you already have a large breed dog and you'd like a small dog. The small dogs are usually the, well, there's medium and small, but I kind of lump them all together. And under like the 25 pound mark is considered more of the small. And then there's the toy group, and some of these are toys as well. But you've got the Maltese, you've got some of the terriers, whether these are rescue mixes, mutts, or what. They all can fall under this 25 pound and under category. You've got Chihuahuas, you've got some Boston Terriers, some Pugs, all those mini doodles. Anything mini is usually going to fall into this category. And they're just not going to need as much space. Although having a small yard or access to a grassy patch outside of your apartment will seriously help keep this pup happy and reduce the work and frustration on your part. So make sure that when you are considering your perfect pet and it's a dog, that you really evaluate the size, because size does matter. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching.
For more on Celebrating Act 2, visit our webpage, follow us on Facebook, subscribe to us on YouTube, and tell your friends. Celebrating Act 2 is the user manual for the second half of your life.